Hi students, good evening everybody. Today I am going to start a new topic, that is differentiation or derivatives. What is differentiation? A function f is said to have derivative if the limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x upon h exists. If this limit exists, then we say that the function f is said to be differentiable function or derivable function with respect to x. Okay, at that point, particularly at x, it is denoted by f dash x is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. If this limit exists, then we say that the function f is said to be derivable function or differentiable function at x with respect to x. Okay, so it is denoted by f dash x, or we can write, so derivable function or differentiable function with respect to x, that is denoted by d by dx of f of x, we can write, or simply f dash x, or dy by dx, or y dash, or y1, like this. Okay, anyway we can denote. So d by dx of f of x means the derivative of f of x with respect to x. Here y is dependent variable, x is independent variable. Okay, y depends on x, remember that. Okay, dy by dx or d by dx of f of x or y1 or y dash. Okay, right? If this limit exists, then we say that f of x plus h minus f of x by h, as limit h tending to 0, this limit exists, then we say that f is a differentiable function or derivable function with respect to x. This is called first principle. First principle or fundamental principle. Fundamental principle. Okay, this limit is called the first principle or fundamental principle. So by using this, we can find the derivatives of the standard functions. Some standard functions we can find, right? So let me find out. First one, find the derivative of, we are going to use all the limit concepts what we have used so far here also. Find the derivative of x using this first principle. Okay, find the derivative of x with respect to x. Okay, let us find out. Solution. Let f of x equal to x. Okay. Now in our limit, what do we have? F of x plus h, right? So find out f of x plus h. Means in the place of x, we should write x plus h. We have, what is our formula? F dash x equal to limit h tending to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. Now we substitute the values here. Limit h tending to 0, what is f of x plus h here? X plus h minus f of x means x upon h. xx gets cancelled. Limit h tending to 0, h by h. This hh also cancel. Since there is no variable here, 1 is the final answer. Therefore, what did you get here? F dash x equal to 1. That is, d by dx of x equal to 1. What does it mean? Derivative of x with respect to x is 1. This is the proof for that. So, we are going to find derivatives of standard functions, trigonometric functions, algebraic functions, logarithmic functions, inverse trigonometric functions, hyperbolic trigonometric functions by using this first principle or fundamental principle. Okay? Just have a look. Okay. Hope it is clear. Let us find the derivative of e power x. Okay? Find the derivative of e power x. Let us see the derivative of e power x with respect to x. That is the second one. Find the derivative of e power x with respect to x. So let f of x equal to, let me take e power x. What do we have? F of x plus h equal to e power x plus h. Right? For doing this, you should remember one formula, standard limit I told you already. E power x minus 1 by x value 1. This is the fundamental standard limit. Okay. So now we have, what is the first principle? F dash x equal to limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x upon h. So substitute the values. Limit h tending to 0, f of x plus h means e power x plus h minus f of x means e power x upon h. So this can be written as limit h tending to 0, e power x plus h, can I write e power x into e power h? Right? Can I write that a power m plus n means a power m into a power n? That equal to limit h tending to 0, take e power x common, e power h minus 1 by h. So since we have h is the variable, e power x can be kept aside. Then limit h tending to 0, e power h minus 1 by h. That value how much? As I told you, that is 1 standard limit. So that into 1 means e power x into 1. That is e power x. So therefore, f dash x equal to e power x. That is d by dx of e power x equal to e power x only. What is the derivative of e power x with respect to x? E power x only. What is the derivative of x with respect to x? That is 1. Okay. Hope it is clear. Let us see one more. Third one. I am going to find out log x. Let me find out log x. Okay. Log x. For that, I like to have not e power x, a power x. Okay? A power x minus 1 by x means log a to the base e. Okay? So, I am going to find out log x. Let me find out log x. Third one. Okay? Let us see. Log x, our function. F of x plus h means what? Log of x plus h. Okay? And now, substitute values here. Limit h tending to 0. F of x plus h means log of x plus h minus log x upon h. Looks like log a minus log b. Log a minus log b equal to log a by b formula. Logarithmic functions, standard formula. So limit h tending to 0, keep 1 by h aside. Log a minus log b means I can write log a by b. Right? So, sorry, x. Right? Now, I am going to split. I am going to split the formula. Limit h tending to 0, 1 by h into log of this x by x. Split x by x means 1 plus h by x. So, 1 plus h by x. Okay? This 1 by h I am shifting into the power. Limit h tending to 0, log of 1 plus h by x whole to the power 1 by h. Okay? Another formula I am going to use here. See this. This is one standard formula. One more formula, what did I use here? M log a. M log a to the base x equal to log a power m to the base x. Okay? Now log can be kept outside. Limit h tending to 0. I can write 1 plus h by x whole to the power 1 by h. Here, whatever you have in this place, h by x is there, no? So in the power we should have reverse x by h. So x is missing there. Multiply and divide. Okay? One standard limit we have, according to that I am doing. Limit h tending to 0, 1 plus h by x whole to the power. H by x means I can write x by h here, whole to the power. What is remaining? 1 by x. Okay? Just see. Right? So, we have one formula here. Limit x tending to 0, 1 plus x whole power 1 by x. That value is e. This limit I am going to use. Standard formula. So, here log is kept outside. Log is kept outside. So, h tends to 0 means h by x tends to also 0. Is it not? H tends to 0 means h by x also tending to 0. Limit you should never forget to change the limit. That log, this complete limit will be whole to the power, this value fully e. So log e power 1 by x. Try to understand that step. This whole term becomes e, log e power 1 by x. So that 1 by x can be brought this side, log e to the base e. Log e to the base e value how much? 1. So what is my answer here? Therefore, f dash x equal to 1 by x. That is d by dx of log x equal to 1 by x. That is the derivative of log x with respect to x. Hope it is clear. What is the derivative of x? 1. Derivative of e power x? E power x. Derivative of log x? 1 by x. Okay, you need to remember the formulae. We shall continue some more in the next class. Thank you.